ice cream, but I'd like to be your favorite wine is with you when you feel alone at night. I'd like to be your lullaby, the white noise you hear when you close your eyes.
So I bought this little tiny soap. This is actually handmade artisan argan oil soap, and a lot of you guys have been asking me like, girl, why is your skin so clear? And honestly, I've been using this. It's just bar soap, so it's not like, I don't know, it's not like specifically for your face or whatever, but because it's natural and it's just argan oil and stuff, it's super natural. And so yeah, it's been working so good for me.
You're like the rain in the morning, the way you clear all my worries. You're like the drugs I'm prescribed, I need to be with you daily. A silver line in the sky, a holiday in my mind, a reason for me to try.
After I wash my face for like 1 minute or something, I go in with this, come on now. You guys know what this is, this witch hazel. Yeah. And what this does is it just rebalances the pH of your skin, and that's what's gonna like prevent acne and stuff like that. Guys, I learned so much about skincare because you guys know when I was really dealing with acne, it was so bad. I learned so much about skincare from the Golden Prescription, from Cassandra, whatever, and Hiram, whatever his name is, and Dr. Drea. And then right here, guys, I know this looks crazy, but this is my moisturizer. Yes, it's in a Ziploc bag. Why? Because I travel all the time, and you're only supposed to bring like 100 milliliters or something of any kind of like cream like this. And my little tub was too big, and so I was like, let me just put this in a bag, okay? Because I am not trying to throw it away. This is CeraVe, it's so good. It's the best moisturizer. Yeah, so this is how my skin is looking. So right now, I'm just gonna take a shower. I'm super happy. This hotel has hot water. Like, a lot of times when I was going places like Airbnbs or hotels, like my previous Airbnb, there was no hot water. And in Chiapas, it is cold. Well, in San Cristobal, it's cold, and so I'd be cold, I'd wake up, I'm cold, I go to the shower, I'm cold, and thankfully, this one has hot water. It's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
I know your body, I know your heart. Your eyes told me from the start, but then you fall back, giving me signs that I've seen before. Yeah, it's cute, but honey, I want more. Don't waste no more time. No, no. There's no use playing hard to get. I figured you out, but you don't know what.
This is a dress that I decided to wear. It's super cute. I literally never buy clothes, but I bought it the other day and I liked it. But right now I'm just about to go eat breakfast, which is just gonna be like some fruit. It's like 10:30 right now. I usually eat breakfast around 12. So I'm kind of eating early today, but I don't know, I was up and at 'em.
There is no tomorrow. Tomorrow never comes. Neither there is any yesterday. One is no more. One is not yet. All that is in our hands is the present moment. And this is a miraculous experience. If there is no yesterday, no tomorrow,
honestly, for me, when I was looking for like a place to live, I wanted somewhere to just be chillax, okay? Like I said, I'm not a city girl, and I feel like lately I've been really thinking about like what it is that I want to do or whatever. Like somebody left a comment like, what do you want to do in 5 years or whatever, and honestly I just want to chill. Like is that so bad to just want to chill? And I don't mean chill like not do anything all day. I mean chill like do whatever I want all day. And that's what I'm doing now, you know, honestly. Like I don't have a lot of responsibilities at all. A lot of people are asking like what I do for work, and yeah, YouTube. Like I make money from YouTube, and actually I'm starting like a new video editing business and everything like that. But my thing is that I do not want to work more. I think it's better to work smarter, which is why I personally prioritize passive income. That's why in my other video, like digital nomad jobs, I talked a lot about how you guys can create passive income, because for me, like I can go a day, 2 days, like I think this year I took 3 months, not 3 months, 2 months off of work, and I was still work meaning YouTube, and I was still making money, because I don't know, it's just I prioritize passive income because I prioritize freedom. I prioritize creativity and being able to do whatever I want all day. And so maybe from YouTube, like I don't know, I can make anywhere from $100 to $300 a day passively. It really just depends on a lot of different factors, honestly. As well as with my books, I can make $100 to $200 a day. And again, I'm starting a new business. That's not going to be passive, but it's going to be something, because, yeah, I just really want freedom. Like, you guys already know, like, I'm planning to be a foster parent, and when I'm a foster parent, like, I want to be able to dedicate as much time to them, the kiddos, as possible. Like, I don't want to have to go to work. I feel like we live in a society where it's so normal to have to go to work, and it's cool. Like, working is cool, whatever, but one, do what you love, and two, work smarter, not harder. And the way to do that is passive income. I'm gonna learn about investing. Like, if you guys wanna see my investing journey and stuff like that, I wanna learn about just financial independence and stuff like that, which is why I save a lot. Like, the reason that, okay, so my favorite place in the world is Hawaii. You guys know how much I love Hawaii, but the reason that I don't live there is because I'm not trying to pay, you know, $1,000 to rent a room there. I'm not trying to pay $2,000 to have my own apartment there. I can, but right now I live abroad. I live in Mexico, and I can save like 50 to 60, even 70% of my income, because maybe monthly my expenses are like $700, $600 a month in total for everything, for my rent, my utilities, my phone, my subscriptions, like everything, and maybe around $600 a month. I can save so much. And when I was living in Hawaii, when I was living in California, I was living like paycheck to paycheck, and just, I don't know, it's not a way to live. And I like the fact that I can take time off, I can do whatever it is that I want, because I prioritized, one, lessening my expenses, and two, creating passive income as well. If you guys, like, I was thinking of making more like finance videos or whatever, because honestly I really grew to love finance because I grew to love freedom, okay? If you want freedom, you gotta learn about finances. If you guys want more videos about that, like I think I'd be down to talk about it. Just let me know, guys, let me know down below. After this I'm gonna go to another garden. I'm learning painting, so I think it'd be cool to paint in the garden or whatever.
Some luck in the book, I don't give a what someone say. Finally got my friends in the back of my roller. We gon' make it big one day. We gon' make it big, I say. We gon' make it big, just stay in the, stay in the moment. Stay in the moment with me. Give you a moment, give you a moment with me. Spend all the roses, spend all the roses with me. Oh,
this one.
Gracias.
Sí.
¿Puedo tener un poquito de agua?
Sí.
Gracias.
It was always on fire, our house, our dreams. We were dancing on a wire, reckless it seemed.
Yeah, I have no idea where I'm going. I'm just trying to follow this path and find a little place that I can sit and do a little bit of painting.
Seems so strong until it falls, the final fall.
Somebody commented on my video and they were like, alone but not lonely. And I was like, yes, because a lot of people on that video surprisingly were like, you're not an introvert, you're lying, you're just trying to get views. I was like, guys, ain't nobody around me, okay? But they were just like, you're an introvert and you like to be on camera? Come on now, I can't believe it. This is so staged. And I was just kind of like, you can be an introvert and like be on camera, you know? I'm not shy at all. Like, I can talk to anybody that I want to. I just usually don't want to talk to people, you know what I mean? And also, a lot of people were like trying to give me the cures for introversion or whatever, but it's like, you don't need a cure for introversion. You know what I mean? Like, being introverted is not a disease or whatever. Like, not everybody's extroverted. And being introverted doesn't have to be like, oh my God, you're crying in the corner and you're miserable and all this stuff. Somebody was like, you're promoting, you're glorifying misery. And I was like, I am not miserable, honey. I like coming places like these in the garden, surrounded by the hummingbirds and the butterflies. And if there was somebody that I loved here, you know, like a really good friend, I'd be talking all the time. But I personally don't see a lot of need for like meaningless relationships. Like, I'm not good at small talk or anything like that at all. I'm fine just being in nature, quiet, painting. I'm not a painter, but I'm trying to get into it. I feel like, I don't know, something about the mountains makes me want to paint, you know? A lot of people were like, you can do this exercise for your introversion or whatever. And I'm like, guys, I can talk to whoever I want. I'm not shy. It's just most of the time, like I said, I don't want to talk to people, okay? Unless it's about something, you know? I don't like small talk. Hola, ¿cómo estás? Oh, yeah, whatever. Not for me. If you guys do like it, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below. And let's see, what should you comment? Tell me what's your favorite hobby or what's a hobby that you're getting into. For example, I'm trying to get into painting. What about you? Let me know so I can know that you watched till the end. Yeah, otherwise, have a good day.